Hello everybody and welcome to The Icon. Many of us aspire to become performing artists. A few of us succeed in becoming a performing artist. But a very few of us, or very few of those fortunate artists, are able to leave a mark of their own in their chosen field. And today, we are blessed to have one such personality who's gone the traditional path, yet created a mark and impression of her own, created a legacy that the world follows today. Ladies and gentlemen, allow me to introduce Dr. Vasundhara Duraiswamy, fondly referred to as Amma, today on The Icon.
Namaste, Namaskaram. Amma. Namaskaram.
Amma, I fall short of words when I have to ask you questions, because as an artist, you're everything that I think an artist aspires to be. At one such time when not many artists ventured out of the traditional path, you chose to experiment with your work. You chose to learn multidisciplinary art forms and combine it all under one roof. I try and do that in my practice these days, but you are one such personality from whom I have drawn a lot of inspiration from. How was it when you started off that way?
Actually, I started my dancing career learning Kathakali. Yes, I was the gold medalist at the age of 5 by presenting Kaliamardana in Kathakali style.
Kathakali, that is something that we Keralites can be always proud of.
My bondage with Malayalam. Yeah. Actually, I was the head of the department in Lasya College of Music and Dance, Payyanur.
Lesser known facts about you.
Yeah. And now my biography is written by one of the Malayali, that is Professor Georges Paul. He is a Hindu paper critic.
Yes.
Dance and music. And after my Kathakali, I started Bharatanatyam. Then I was studying yoga too. When I'm doing yoga, I found that there are so much similarities in yoga and Bharatanatyam. And by practicing Bharatanatyam as a practitioner of yoga, I thought that it is very useful for every dancers. Yoga is very important to any style of dance. Because of the yoga, I found that the willpower, the stability in the postures, the stamina, the memory power, and the expressions we should involve in that character, and using our pranayama, we get more emotions, as we can show that in our dance. And I learned Kalaripayattu too, and I am using Kalaripayattu, the sword, and Thangta, Manipur this art also. I am using those Kalaripayattu and Thangta in my dance dramas. When we are showing the doing the dance dramas, we are adapting different styles also in that. But in the boundary, only traditional boundary, I am not going out of the boundary. Yeah, I am experimenting anything in that boundary. The traditional is very important for me, because this dance art is spiritual. I am always believing that this is the divine art. We are telling the we want to uplift the audience to higher level, not to stoop down. This is the artist, our responsibility. Yeah, that's why whatever I do, the experiment within that tradition I'm doing, and I'm adapting Kalaripayattu and tangta in my dance dramas only, not in my traditional items. When we are showing war, for example, Mahishasura or Devi, at that time we are using sword fight. And I like the vodivus in Kalaripayat, the postures. Once we performed this one, lecture demonstration, one Kalaripayat, one Bharatanatyam and Kathakali. We are showing all the, for example, fish, how we are showing. But in Bharatanatyam, we are standing in Swastika Pada and doing the mudra.
Doing the mudra.
Yeah, but when I'm showing the Veerabhadrasana, that is also in Kalaripayat also we are showing. They're very similar. One thread is going out through all the performing arts, that is yoga. That is, yoga is very important. I found all those things to combine together, and I don't want to doing all the experiments and to become the famous. But I thought that it is necessary for me. And it is good, whatever, maybe everyone has that creative mind. Let them do, but let them do in that tradition. That is my advice to everyone.
Amma, I felt that most of our texts are so interlinked to each other that sometimes when you study the Natyashastra deeper, when you look at all the Karna Vedas, yeah, the 108 Karnas, which are very seldom practiced by practitioners of Bharatanatyam these days, there are a lot of elements of yoga that comes into the Karnas. While we look at Hatha Yoga Pratibhiga, the asanas explained in there and the Karnas, we draw parallels between these two. However, I've noticed that most Bharatanatyam dancers refrain from using expressive bodily movements and confined to expressions. Expressions are beautiful. I think Indian classical art form is one such that is so blessed with the beauty of expressions. However, bodily expressions using karanas and using other movements, like how you use yogic movements, are very less often experimented. I've often felt that it is probably because people don't dare to push their bodies beyond a certain limit. They do not want to. Or sometimes they're limited by their age. However, you have never ever shown any trace of being limited by any of those factors.
Yeah, for any classical dance, we need four types of expressions. Angika, Vachika, Ahari and Satvika. One thing nowadays, we are lack of Satvika, because Bharatanatyam is the solo-oriented dance. Now we are coming to a big stage and they want every time the group. In group dance, no creativity. The synchronization and formations, these are all very important. And Aharya, they are giving more importance to the Aharya. The same color dresses and lights, the formations, all these things are, this is the entertainment, but not to your actual, for heart. This one, Sachidananda, or to your heart.
How you feel the emotion.
See, if you are going to a drama, for example, Othello's Shakespeare dramas, that is all Dukkhanta. In the end, it is, we are all crying by seeing the drama. But when we are coming out, such a beautiful drama. What the acting and what is the expressions? What is the beautiful drama? We feel so happy.
Rasana.
That happiness should be there after seeing the performance. Not only not like provoking the audience, it should be satisfaction to your mind. That is very important of our art, that is Indian culture.
Have you felt that other classical dancers don't choose to move like you do because they can't?
Because of yoga, even now I am dancing continuously 3 hours without taking a 1 minute rest in between, and full of nritta too.
In fact, Australia has been honored to be a part of your 70th birthday celebration.
Yes. Yeah.
And for those who witnessed the magic of that performance, when we are celebrating over a year throughout the world, when all your students throughout the world are celebrating your 70th birthday, and you reward them with an hour and a half long performance. And it's not just mere abhinaya or you know, a storytelling, but a complete package where you inspire and you create a world of your own with your bodily movements.
One thing we should practice a lot. Practice is very important. There's also after age of 30, most of the dancers, they are because they have started to teach. Then they are sitting and doing the natvanga only. Taiya, taigi, they are doing only the natvanga, not dancing. But I am always telling my students, whenever you are teaching, you stand in front of them and dance with them. That is all the audibles. But when it comes to an item, they should do the natvanga and tell the shulkat. But when you are doing the adavus, the steps, fundamental units of Bharatanatyam, you should do with the students. Then only we'll be perfect. Then when you are dancing, it is coming so easily. And the passion is very important. That is very important for every artist. The passion towards this art. First of all, you learn how to enjoy your moments by yourself. Then only people can enjoy. That is very important for a dancer.
Amma, you've portrayed a lot of strong female characters.
Yes.
Through your art.
Yeah.
You are one such strong female character as well. Your latest work, Amma, The Untold Story.
Yes.
Could you elaborate on that?
That is the last days of Krishna. That is conversation between the between Krishna and his mothers. Here I brought three mothers. The first one is Devaki, the second one is Yashoda, and third one, anybody knows? The third one is Putana.
She's fed Krishna. Yes?
Yeah, and actually, everybody is thinking that Putana is a demon. Like that, everybody is showing like that. But it is not like that. She is also a girl.
There is Vatsalya.
Yeah. Yeah. Because of the this circumstances, she became a poisonous lady. Because Kamsa has fed her every day the poison, little by little, from the young baby. She was a very beautiful girl. That's why he was using her for his political things. When she became a grown-up girl, she come to know that she is a poisonous lady and she is known as Vishakanya. When she come to know that she is going to kill, he is sending her to Krishna, to kill Krishna, then on her way, she was going to Gokula. She was listening some pravachana was going on there. Then Sita is telling to Hanumanta, why are you scolding these demons who are around me? Don't be like that. We should tell, we should punish Ravana. He has told to them
to behave,
yeah,
such.
That's why that is not their fault. If he was telling that you should treat her so nicely, they would do like that. That's why that is not their fault. All these sins and all the papa, punya, everything is going to Ravana, not to them. Then she thinks that, oh, then there is no papa for me. I am not doing it purposely because Kamsa told me, he is feeding me. That's why I am listening to his orders. There is no, then she is thinking that now I am getting moksha in Krishna's hands. And when she is saying Krishna, he is smiling at her And she thinks that such a beautiful smile, Krishna, what shall I give you? Everybody is giving so many gifts to you, but I have nothing to offer you. I have only milk now. I can feed you with the milk. Please, Krishna, take the milk. And she's telling that I am also just like everybody. I'm also a girl. I have also all that affection.
A mother.
Motherhood, this one. And she once fell in love with one person and she became pregnant. And because of her poisonous body, she lost her lover and the child also. Then she's telling that, I am also a girl. Please think that I am a lady. I am a woman. I have all that feeling, motherly feeling. When she was feeding Krishna, she was feeling like that, oh, my motherhood was now satisfied, like that. Finally, she is offering her life to Krishna. Krishna Arpana, Krishna Arpana.
And that is how she attains moksha.
Yes.
How does such ideas come to you, Amma?
Because we should study a lot. Not only performing, theory is very important for every dancer. By studying theory, we will know that without our every time go to the book and go there and what hasta we should use for this one, what adobo, no, it comes automatically by reading, we will get it. And read all these mythological episodes or go study, go deep into that art, then you will get all these ideas. The creativeness is in every way. In every artist you have creativeness. You should develop that one.
What would your advice be to artists who want to take up dance as a full-time career?
They should practice and devote themselves to the art. Don't for fix success. Study it, love it, dedicate and practice. That is very important.
What do you think about your students in Australia?
Nowadays, students?
Students in Australia.
In Australia, I have seen so many artists here. Really, they are very much interested in this art and they are doing so much work for this art.
Because how are they different
from... coming from India. Mm. It is very difficult to them. They don't have live music here, or but the children have their own professions, or they are very busy with their studies. Even in India also, it is like that. But here they have not much scope for them. But they should study the theory too. And all the young dancers who are here, they are teaching, and they are doing some experiment works also and promoting the artists. I'm very happy about this in Australia.
And we are glad that there is Vasundhara Bani that is being established in Australia through your daughter-in-law, Meghala.
Yeah, Meghala.
Do you ask her to keep practicing as well?
Yes, of course.
What a blessed life it is.
Throughout the world this year they are celebrating my 70th birthday. I'm visiting everywhere, US, UK, Singapore, all the places, and I'm performing there, and they're really propagating my style, Vasundhara Bani. That is not Vasundhara Bani. I learned the Pandanalu style. When I'm doing this yoga and all these things, I am thinking that there is something we can
unique
do.
Unique about how you do it.
Yeah, because in some moments I thought that if I look like that, according to my personality too, I softened some of the movements and some of the postures, I changed it, and it became Sundara Bani. by three generations it has come.
We look forward to reading your biography by Professor George Paul.
George Paul, yeah, he's right.
And when is that being released, Amma?
That is on November 2nd. November 1st is my birthday, actually. They are celebrating in Mysore for 4-5 days. And second, the book releasing function, and Sonal Mansingh is coming for that to release the function.
We are very certain that with the sadhana that you're doing, we will in another 30 years be celebrating your 100th birthday as well. May God give you all the grace and blessing that He's always showered you with. And thank you so much for spending time with us on The Icon and with our audience today.
Thank you.
Once again, thank you so much, Amma.
I'm very grateful to M4 Malayalam for this interview. Really, they are promoting the art, supporting the art. Congratulations.
Thank you so much, Amma.